the Nation of Gods and Earths, also called the Five Percenters, was an organization that broke away from the Nation of Islam in the early 1960s. And members don't see it as a breakaway. I think some of them see it as a more true inhabiting of some of the core teachings of the Nation of Islam. But it was a less formal organization. Members didn't have to dress in the suits and wear the bow ties and so forth. What they had, they were founded by a man named Father Allah, and they used a mystical code system of letters called the Supreme Alphabet and numbers called the Supreme Mathematics, which they used on a daily basis to reflect upon their own lives in accordance with their scriptures and their teachings. It's very mysterious to outsiders, using a lot of vocabulary that definitely shut out people who weren't supposed to know. And the primary teaching was that 85% of people are mentally dead. They've been tricked into submitting to authority, into oppression. 10% are the evil, essentially, controllers, exploiters, people who take advantage of the poor and the dispossessed. But that 5% are what they call the poor, righteous teachers, whose job it is to teach what they know to those who do not know. That's why some of them call themselves the 5% Nation. And they are also called the Nation of Gods and Earths.
Once we have the knowledge of self as a people, then we can be free. No devil could ever enter the boundaries. I'm standing in the center around all these sounds I see. Blessed alive that I found the key. That's how we be.
We are by no means ashamed of our cultural background. Not a tad bit afraid of change. Look around, look the same old, same old.
Hey, what's going on, man?
Oh, no, I can't call it. Trying to maintain over the giving boundaries. I gotta be righteous, I gotta be me. I gotta be conscious, I gotta be free. I gotta be able, I gotta attack. I gotta be stable, I gotta be black.
Who is that surrounding me? Enemy, enemy, you cross the wrong boundary. Poof, wicked witness, wizardry. Disappear from here and end up in the tree.
The influence that the Nation of Gods and Earths has had on popular culture has been huge, and most people don't know this until you start researching it. It's not clear at all, but the foundation of hip-hop, really, as many people know, think of hip-hop as beginning in the Bronx and beginning with Jamaican DJs or selectors who came over and used their style in order to create hip-hop. But what they don't know is that within the Five Percenters or the Nation of Gods and Earths, people were required to memorize scriptures, to engage in debates and exegeses on their scriptures, where they would explain the meanings of those in relation to their lives. And so they became extremely adept in wordplay, in backronyms, taking words and using each letter to create new meaning, a sentence of these letters. And as a result, people became extremely good at rhyme, at rhythmic speech, at public speaking, and they created a new poetry that really had not existed before, fusing it with the musical elements that they had at their disposal. And as a result, a huge proportion of the most famous rappers at the core of hip-hop, people like Rakim, Eric B, the DJ, the Wu-Tang Clan, Busta Rhymes, Lakim Shabazz, the Poor Righteous Teachers, and so many others, they actually are part of this religious, and they do not see themselves in any way as a religion. In fact, they would say that they're against religion, but as this part of this mystical system, it's a hidden history of hip-hop.
Thinking of a master plan. Death with the record. Death with the record. Thinking of a master plan. Death with the record. Death with the record. Thinking of a master plan. This ain't nothing but sweat inside my hands. So I dig into my pocket, all my money spent. So I just deep up, still coming up with lint. So I start my mission, leave my residence. Thinking how could I get some dead presidents? I need money. I used to be a stick-up kid. So I think of all the devious things I did.
I was fascinated about the Nation of Gods and Earths, the Five Percenters, ever since I found out about them through hip-hop in the mid to late 1980s, particularly, I guess, because of Rakim, who used a lot of references in his rhymes. And as I read more and more about them as the internet grew, I always wanted, as a writer of what I call Imhotep-Hop, I wanted to be able to take the stories, the histories of African realities of any part of the world, whether it's the United States or Somalia, ancient Egypt called Kemet, South Africa, any part. And I wanted to be able to take those stories and put them into a new context for people to discover them, because most people don't want to read history books, but they will read an interesting story. So if I can symbolize real life events through stories, I can do that. And here was a history that was so rich. It was rich in its symbolism, its own allegories, its own struggles, its own heroes, its own villains, its own actual iconography, the universal flag of the nation of gods and earth, all that. I thought, let me tell that story. And at the same time, I never write about just one thing. I always want to write about multiple things. So I wanted to tell the story of Sudanese lost boys, and I wanted to tell the story of this explosive growth of the Somali-Canadian community in E-Town, and I wanted to tell the story about the crisis that community is under, particularly the young men. And I wanted to tell the story about community organizing, and I wanted to tell the story of ancient Egypt and the origin story of Heru, known as Horus in English, and Yinapu, known as Anubis. And I wanted to tell that story and put them all together so that many communities would find something of themselves or their interest in it. And I think that's what makes for a much more dynamic novel than just saying, well, I'm just going to very narrowly tell this one tale. You know, right now I don't know how members of the Nation of Gods and Earths, the 5%ers, will respond to the book. I was able to reach out to a couple of people, NGE bloggers, and ask them to read the book in advance and to give me some feedback, and also to review the book, whether they liked it or disliked it, but to put their voice out there. And mostly what they told me was, look, some of the members, some of the Gods and Earths, they will love it. And some of them will hate it, because that's just the way, you know, they're not a monolithic community where everybody thinks alike. They're just like every other group of people. They've got a diverse set of opinions. So I in no way wrote this to try to stir up controversy, but rather to celebrate a fascinating cultural tradition that I think has much in it that is worthy of emulation, just as much worthy of emulation in so many other new North American mystical, cultural, ideological formation.
I was born underwater with $3 and 6 dimes. Yeah, you may laugh, 'cause you did not do your math. Like 1, 2, 3. Damn, y'all feel it?
I hope that like they will love the book and see that I'm trying to celebrate a lot of the things in their culture. And I want to stress that while there are parallels to many of the figures in their history, no character in the book is supposed to be a replica. So they'll find aspects of Father Allah and his life in one of the characters, and aspects of some of the other characters and people from their history. But no, if they find something they dislike about one of my characters, it doesn't mean that it's in their history. It's something that tells the story.